Hello, Detective. I think you will find this interesting. A series of murders took place in the city. Just recently, another one happened in the city theater. I'll meet you at the crime scene. Your help with the case of the Plague Doctor was invaluable, so I thought asking for your help again is a good idea. Recently, a string of three murders happened in the city. We found no link between them, except that they happen in alphabetic order. The latest murder happened this morning. The victim, Colin Cox, was a young actor, a recent graduate. The theater is sealed already, so you are free to look around for clues. I'll ask the patrol to bring your car and equipment. Colin's dressing room is worth taking a look. If you find any clues or strange presents, don't forget to hand them over to me. Take this. After all, maybe the criminal is still hiding around here. Interesting. I saw the same tags at Adam's boutique. He was the second victim. Perhaps we missed something, and it seems that the murders are connected after all. You can go there and take a look. Arnold's son also showed up there recently. His name is Fred Jones. I think he arrived before Adam's murder and took up residence there. The police had to breach the boutique's door, so the lock is damaged. I think you can open it, though. You can get to the boutique through an alley. I'll go to the department and register our clues. Please take this hairpin spoke as a sign of my gratitude. It could be useful. I informed my colleagues of your involvement in this case, so visit the theater anytime.
I heard a noise downstairs and got here as fast as I could.
Who are you? What are you doing here?
Sorry, police called me recently and said that you could come. After all, I came to the city to find my father, Arnold Adams. I moved in here on the second floor of the boutique, but didn't even spend 3 days with him before his death. I was too late. Soon I will meet my father's lawyer and return to my mother. You can take a look at Arnold's workshop. Arnold told me a lot about the workshop.
Thank you. Dear Arnold, in a couple days, my wife Norma will come back from her holiday trip. I invite you and, if you wish so, your former employee Colin to our estate. We'll discuss our continued cooperation, my sponsorship, and have a good time in general. I've attached the address to the letter in case you've forgotten it.
I'm sorry, but I have to meet my lawyer. I have to close the boutique.
Help me put out the fire. Thank you so much. My name is Barbara. I'm the maid here. Norma Brooks could be in danger. Please, check on her. I will look around the fire. Maybe the criminal dropped something. A lot of smoke could still be inside the house after the fire. Take my cap. It'll help you if that's the case.
Bye. Who are you?
Detective.
Oh, right. So he broke into it, took the documents, and escaped through the window. Please find out why he came here. The letter says Benji knew someone was following him. He was worried about his and my safety. So he hid all the copies of the documents. Oh, you have to keep looking for traces of that person, and maybe we can find those copies.
Thank you.
this? There's all kinds of strange papers. Real estate, a secret will, and so on. Gather everything you found and wait for the police. Thinking about my husband like this, it's pretty sad. I'll ask Barbara to make me some soothing tea. Drinking tea by myself is bad manners for a host. Please, drink some with me. As it turns out, my husband tried to persuade Adams not to hand over the business to his son, but to pool his capital. Perhaps his son found out about it and killed Adams and my Benji. When the police arrive, we'll give it to them right away. Good job, Barbara. This fool never saw it coming. He actually fell for it and thought that we called the police. You've done an excellent job investigating this case, even managing to find Benji's papers, which I didn't expect. But now I have no more time to bother you. This will be your final resting place. Goodbye.
Thank God you're all right. Norma seems suspicious to me from the beginning. Unfortunately, I hid them somewhere here. So they conspired with Barbara. I'm afraid he might be Norma's next target. Please help me fix Mr. Brooks's boat so that I can take you to town in it. I found this brooch. All right, get in. And let's go to the police station. You must show this evidence to the officer in charge of investigating the murders and convince her to visit Mr. Evans. I'll drop you off and go straight to him. I have to warn him because he might be in danger.
Excuse me. There's a lot of commotion at the station right now. We arrested Fred Jones on suspicion of murder, and during the search of his home, we found blank phone books and murder weapons. It looks like the case has already been solved. Wait, where did you get that? It's pretty surprising. I don't really understand what Norma and Barbara's motives might be, but I'll trust you. I know where Elliot Evans' office is. He used to be notorious for his involvement in not-so-legal deals. Convincing him to cooperate would be very difficult. Oh no! We've got to send help to Evans right away!
Please, help me. I'm injured and can't open the lock on the door by myself.
Stay here and help Mr. Evans, and I'll go catch the culprit.
Thank you. I'll sit down and try to gather myself. Donovan came here just before you did and told me about Norma and Barbara. Then Norma broke in and attacked us. Donovan tried to stop her. When Norma started shooting, he managed to push me into the archive and lock me there. I miraculously survived. Thanks to him, I am very sorry that he's gone.
Ugh, the perp jumped down and almost instantly ran into an alleyway. Not one of my bullets reached them, and by the time I got downstairs and followed them, they were already lost in the streets. But I doubt they had time to pick up their stuff, which means it's probably still out there somewhere. Please find it. I'll stay with Mr. Evans in case they come back to finish the job. Here, this might come in handy. looks like Norma's handkerchief. Mr. Evans, please help us solve this case.
There are indeed many of Mr. Brooks's secret papers here in the archives. There are papers on his transactions, including a second copy of a secret will. I can't tell you everything. Yes, I admit that Mr. Brooks cheated all these people and bought land from them cheaper than its market value, but it's their own fault for not reading the contract. So, you see, it's not my fault. I will still help you, though. Many of them were dissatisfied with the results of the real estate transactions and tried to challenge them. Most of these people were single and died long ago, but Mr. Willoughby had two daughters. I should have his address in my documents. I'll find it for you now, and you can take my car.
I can't believe my eyes. My own daughter threatened to kill me when I said I would report everything to the police. I've called her Alina for years. As their father, I cannot allow them to continue these atrocities. My daughter Alina, I mean Barbara, kept a diary as a child. Maybe it will help. You can look for it here. You can visit their old room. It's been so long.
Dad, don't say anything.
Nothing will ever be the same again, Alina. My daughter's real names are Alina and Adelaide Willoughby. As you can see, Brooks robbed us of everything, and shortly after we moved. But the girls... You can use my phone.
Oh, it's you. Found something else? Great. Now we have all the proof we need. I'll send a unit to pick up Barbara. They'll take her to the police station. My informant has just reported that Norma was seen at the train station with a ticket. Please get there as soon as possible, or she may get away. Oh no, we missed her. Norma got on the train under a false name. We might still catch her before the train leaves, though. I'll go talk to the station master. He's already agreed to hold the train, but he's worried that people will be angry. By the way, Fred asked me to tell you that he was grateful that you were trying to clear his name. We ordered meals for the passengers at his expense. It might help us make up for the delay. Look for Norma while I get everything ready.
Attention, dear passengers, the train's departure is delayed. We apologize for the inconvenience. As compensation, we have prepared free lunches that you can take with you. Please claim them at the canteen and have a pleasant journey.
Let me go. You don't have any proof.
We have examined all the documents and evidence you have found. There is no doubt that Norma and Barbara, or Alina and Adelaide, to be precise, will be found guilty. Fred Jones was cleared of all charges, and he appears to be the sole heir to both Adams and Brooks estates. It seems he intends to thank you personally and give you an interview. He says that he's going to renegotiate all of Brooks' deals and return the unfairly taken properties. The police are also interested in Elliot Evans' activities. Who knows which crimes will turn up there? In any case, on behalf of the police, I offer you my gratitude. Great job once again.
Hello? Can you hear me? It's Fred. I'm sorry to bother you, but I'm in trouble. After I was cleared of all charges, I continued my father's business in his fashion house. And it was great. I even got an order from Whitney Winslet herself to make her a concert dress. But afterward, Whitney got really sick with some mystery disease. And her doctor was sure it was because of my dress. So they arrested me for harming her. I'm at the police station, and unfortunately, the time for this call is running out. Please help. You're my only hope. Whitney lives at 17 Freedom Street in the Celebrities District. Talk to her and get to the bottom of this. Hurry.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Dr. Vernon Murphy. I'm Ms. Winslet's family physician. Ms. Winslet wants everyone in town to know what a nasty fashion designer Fred Jones is, and she's willing to give an interview about it to the press. So if you're a reporter, please feel free to stay.
Hello. Oh, I know you. I've been reading your articles, like the Alphabet Murders. It was a fascinating detective story. But Mr. Johnson should not have been put in charge of a fashion house. His dress gave me terrible burns all over my body. I'm still in so much pain. And it was the dress I was wearing during a very important concert. All the higher-ups were there, and my outfit made quite a splash.
Her fever got worse. She needs a solution of butterbur, a plant that relieves allergy symptoms. Please pick some and make a mixture of them. I have to monitor Whitney's condition, and I can't take my eyes off her. If her fever progresses further, I'll have to give her an antibiotic. She's very weak. I wouldn't want to use it unless absolutely necessary, so I can't get distracted. Please, hurry.
thanks. I feel better already.
Whitney has a very severe and serious allergy to cheap fabric, which is not used to make dresses nowadays. But Whitney's dress for that fateful concert was made from that hazardous material. This fabric, though quite beautiful to look at, is very rough to the body. I'm appalled that such a big and famous fashion house cut corners to sew a most luxurious dress. They quite harmed Whitney. You should deal with this outrageous case without delay.
You can examine the dress to make sure that it was made with this awful material. It's in my closet, but I lost the key somewhere. When you get this sorted out, please tell me why the dress was made from such cheap fabric. I need to know. Was it a mistake? Malice towards me, or just austerity? Someone at the atelier has been plotting against me. Please get to the bottom of this as soon as possible. I'm no longer convinced that Fred is guilty. It would be idiotic because all the evidence leads to him. He must have been set up.
Here is the address of the atelier. Please hurry and question all the employees involved. I am concerned for Whitney, and I fear that the offender may try to harm her again.
Hello, my name is Marlene. I have worked at Fred's model house. The dress for Whitney was made by Elise. Fred had been spending a lot of time in it. You can also take a look at Fred's office.
Hello? I have to tell you, here, we're working on dresses that are specially designed for the most famous people. Oh, well, you found proof. Here, this is the piece of fabric I made Whitney's dress from. I didn't know it would turn out like this. Now that you know my secret, I have nothing to lose. I once stole a dress from the atelier. I took it just for one night to go on a date with a young man. But Marlene found out and said that the word would reach Fred if I didn't do her bidding. Marlene brought the fabric and the sketch and told me to make a dress out of this particular material. I was surprised that the dress for Whitney should be made out of chiffon, such a cheap and awful fabric. But I made it, and I said I wouldn't tell anyone. Marlene rents an apartment in a poor neighborhood, 101 C Brooklyn Street. I think she knows more than I do. Talk to her.
thank you very much for your vital assistance. Now Marlene will get a minor prison sentence for harming Whitney.
I'm so grateful. I'm free only because of you. You should know, I've already apologized to Marlene for stealing her dress design. I even publicly acknowledged her authorship of the dress. Here, take a look.